Hey everyone, welcome back to my show. Hope you are doing great. Today I'm going to talk about one of the very important topic, India's healthcare system. India is very famous for its medical tourism. Lots of people from different countries come to India for medical treatments because for them, healthcare in India is less expensive and has good quality. And no doubt, India has one of the very talented and expert medical workforces in the world. In 2018, the market for healthcare in India was $116 billion, which is estimated to reach $372 billion by 2022, which would make a big contribution to India's GDP. If a country is healthy, then only it can grow fast. This is all on the good side. Now let's talk about healthcare problems. But before that, if you find this video useful and informative, please share it with your friends and family so that they can benefit from it. So the first and most important problem is not having enough healthcare professionals. Even though India's spending on the healthcare has doubled since 2014, it is still very low. Only 1,944 rupees per person, which is only 1.29% of the GDP. As per World Bank data, India has only 20 healthcare workers per 10,000 of its people, which is less than one healthcare worker for 1,000 people. This number is very well below the WHO's minimum requirement of 23. In this case, India is not only behind China, Japan and the US, but behind Pakistan as well. The saddest thing is almost 80% of healthcare workers are present in urban areas. This means for around 65% of Indians who live in rural areas, there is only 25% of the healthcare workforce is available. On the other hand, the overall quality of healthcare in India is very poor, because of which more people die due to poor quality of healthcare than not having access to it. The second very important problem is the poorly regulated healthcare system. The reason behind this is, in India, healthcare is the responsibility of the state government, which makes it very difficult to bring and implement uniform healthcare regulations in the entire country. The healthcare sector in India is not very well regulated, and as a result of it, the average cost of treatment at a private hospital is 7 times higher than what it would cost at government hospitals. I know, government hospitals are not well hygienic and not of a high quality, but even by considering that cost, charging a person 7 times higher cannot be justified. This is the reason most of the people in India do not check themselves into hospitals when they have some non-fatal disease, or at least keep on delaying it just to avoid the high cost of treatments. Not having a well-regulated healthcare sector is the main reason India has so many fake doctors. It is surprising that the country famous for its medical talent has 53% of fake doctors as per a WHO report. This is so bad that I read in news people from Delhi traveled to Himachal Pradesh using fake corona negative report from a doctor by paying a small amount of money. The third critical point is government spending and healthcare insurance. It is very sad that government spending on healthcare is only around 1.15% of the GDP. And you will be shocked to know that, as per WHO, India ranks 184th out of 191 countries in terms of GDP percentage spending on healthcare. If government spending will be increased, health insurance problems can be minimized, as health insurance is very important to deal with unplanned medical emergencies. Because of the lack of awareness, most of the Indians think that health insurance is a liability or waste of money, whereas it is an investment you make for your future. Data shows that more than half of the Indian population does not have any sort of health insurance. I'm pretty sure that most of you who are very well educated do not have it either. And 90% of the poor people do not have any sort of health insurance. After the advent of Ayushman Bharat in 2018, which is healthcare for the poor from the government, 45% of the poor have been covered. But still, there is very little awareness about these government schemes between these people, and it should be increased. With all this in mind, let me ask you a question. What do you think why the Indian government is opening up the country even if the coronavirus cases are rising? On the other hand, when there were very few coronavirus cases in March in India, we had a complete lockdown. Why is it so? The reason is our healthcare system. Let me explain it. At the start of the coronavirus in March, the Indian healthcare system was not ready and was not well equipped to fight the coronavirus. As we know, in March, there was negligible production of PPE and availability of ventilators in India, which are very essential to fight coronavirus. And here they took the help of lockdown. And during that 2.5 months of lockdown, the Indian government prepared and equipped itself with all the necessary tools to fight the coronavirus. Even today, we do not have enough beds to accommodate all virus-infected patients. I know what you must be thinking, that no country in the world was ready for this, and how could anyone expect it from India? But at least, other countries were partially equipped to fight a pandemic like this, and they did not have to suddenly lock down the country, leaving small wage workers like migrant workers stranding high and dry, begging for their lives. Lots of people had to shut their businesses and stay home unprepared, and the result of this was the downfall of the economy, which could have been avoided if India had well-equipped healthcare sector. There are several countries like New Zealand, Zealand, South Korea, Hong Kong that have effectively handled the COVID situations with no or little lockdown measures. You might say that India is a densely populated country, but you won't believe me that Hong Kong is almost 14 times denser than India, and the density of South Korea is slightly higher than that of India, yet they effectively handled the pandemic. Definitely, India is different and has its own challenges, but if we spread awareness about the healthcare system and take it seriously, India can very soon become one of the healthiest countries in the world. And in order to avoid situations like this in future, it is very important for us to understand the importance of the healthcare system in a nation, and we must demand better healthcare from the government. We should vote only to candidates who are committed to make India a better place. Healthier the country, healthier the economy. So that's it for today, guys. Do let me know in the comment section what do you think about this video. And if you find this video useful, please share it with your friends and family and do subscribe to our channel. Bye bye, take care.